this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to use a screen recording program called Loom. If your teacher is asking you to use Loom, it's likely that it's already been installed on your browser and you can see it up here as a Google Chrome extension. If it hasn't already been installed, make sure you talk with your teacher to figure out how to get it on your computer. Essentially, what Loom does is capture anything that you are doing on your screen. So your teachers might ask you to do this to prove that you're able to do something on a computer, or they might have you record your screen so that they can figure out what's going wrong if you're having a problem. So let's take this assignment, for example, and say that your teacher asks you to record your screen to search for sources online about your favorite animal. What you would do is go up to the Loom icon, click it. You're going to see that your image is going to pop up in the corner. If you want that image to go away, you can just click screen only. Then you are going to be asked whether or not you want to record your full desktop or just the current tab. Record your full desktop because if you don't, it's only going to record what is on this single tab. And if you're doing things like going to multiple places, then that's going to get lost. Once you're ready to start recording, all you need to do is click Start Record. Then it's going to prompt you whether or not you want to share your entire screen or the application window. Go ahead and just click Entire Screen and click Share. You'll see a countdown, and after the numbers count down, you can go ahead and perform your action for whatever it is that your teacher is asking you to do. So in this case, for example, I might show that I am able to find a source by looking for some information about my favorite animal. And then you would want to go through the websites and explain to your teacher why you think you found a website that is reliable, which this one probably is not. While you're recording, you can tell it's recording because it's going to be pulsating red on your Loom icon. If you want to pause your recording because you need to catch your breath or you just want to pause it for whatever reason, you can click the pause button down below. That will pause your recording. And then in order to get it back, you just click on that box and it will continue to record again. Now, once you're finished recording, you can either click on that green check there, or you can click on the Loom extension. Both of those will end your recording. When you finish the recording, it's going to send you to a page, and on this page, you'll be able to see the final version once it's finished. You can also choose to change the title of the document if your teacher wants you to do that. And then once the recording has loaded, you'll see that you can play it back and watch it. And if you notice that there's a part that you would prefer to cut out, you can easily do that by going to the Trim tool. When you select Trim and then click Start Trimming, you'll see that it pulls up a little bar that will allow you to cut sections of your video. So let's say, for example, that in the middle of your video, you made a small mistake. It's not a big deal. Just slide it over to that section. And then when you want to remove it, just click Remove. Then click Publish Changes in order to return to your main screen. And that is going to now publish the new version of your video that has that edit in it. Your teacher is, of course, going to tell you how they want you to submit this assignment. It's really easy to get the link. All you need to do is click Copy Link. And then if your teacher wants you to submit it in Google Classroom, you can just paste the link there. Or sometimes a teacher might have you just paste the link directly to your Loom video on a document that you created. So for example, here, I could just go below the instructions. I could go up to Edit and Paste, and that's going to paste that link into the document. I want to make sure that I highlight it and click on that little Insert Link Hyperlink button so that it turns into a live link. And you'll notice if you click on it, it's going to take you right to that video. All right, I hope you learned how incredibly easy it is to record your screen using Loom.